everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm here to do a what's in my diaper bag video and a mini review of the Ryla diaper bag. My daughter is 14 months old, so I'm going to show you what I normally carry around when we go out of the house, and then I'll show you all the different features of this diaper bag. So I prefer a diaper bag that is a backpack. It's just so much easier to carry around versus one that is on the shoulder or crossbody. They just seem to get in the way and they always make my back hurt. So what I normally pack is a snack cup. Normally a snack cup has either Cheerios or animal crackers in it, whatever's easier at that point. And this Munchkin straw cup. This is what she really likes, and we really like it for water, and it's super easy because I can close the straw in and I know it's not gonna leak. Now the next few things I'll show you are in the main part of the diaper bag. So I always go out with a few diapers. Now we use the Honest Company diapers, so I do have the Honest Company diapers and wipes. Next, I always carry a wet bag. This is an Itsy Ritsy snack bag, but it kind of works the same. And it was the right size because it doesn't take up much room in the diaper bag, but it is lined. So you're not going to have, if anything spills, you're not going to have any problems with that. So in this, I always carry some sort of diaper cream. This was just a sample of the 7th Generation Coconut Care. I carry the Arm & Hammer diaper bags. These are for if you have a really stinky diaper or anything like that. A lot of times I'll use these for dirty clothes or anything that I don't want anything else to touch. I always carry Draft Stain Remover. Again, my kid is very messy and she refuses to wear a bib, so we carry this everywhere we go. And that's all that I have in there right now. If she's teething or she isn't feeling well, usually I will carry Tylenol in here as well. Next, I just have a travel pack of silverware for her. She's learning to use forks and spoons, so that's really helpful. I always keep extra socks and an extra outfit. And I always carry a USB cord for my phone as well. I've just found it's really helpful to have it to plug into the car or into the computer, or if I need to print pictures, it's always good to have this on hand. The next few items I show you are I keep in the pockets. So in this pocket out here, I just have the travel placemats for when we go out to eat. We don't go out too often, but these do come in handy if I need her to eat something and she doesn't want to eat off a plate. I have the Baby Gannix hand sanitizer. And then this next little pocket, I just keep a pacifier or two. She doesn't really use these during the day, but she needs them for nap time and everything like that. So if we're going to my parents' house or my in-laws' house, it's very convenient to have that. Now these two back pockets are sippy cup pockets. I currently don't have a sippy cup in here that requires insulation, so that one is empty. But in here I just have an extra pair of jammies. A lot of times too when I carry diapers, I'll carry one overnight diaper from the Honest Company. That way if we're out and we're not gonna be back to the house by the time it's her bedtime, I can just dress her in her PJs and we can transfer her right from the car to the crib, no problem. And along with that, I also have another pair of socks to go with that outfit. Now the only other few things I have in here is in this front pocket, I carry my wallet. Now this pocket in the front is not very big, so it only really fits a smaller wallet. This wallet is about as long as like a checkbook, if that makes sense, and this one's not very thick, so it fits really well. And I carry a few items for me. So I have a couple of lip glosses and a lipstick. Now, it does have two side pockets. I just have a bow clipped here for her now that she wears them. And this one's empty. Usually I just put my water bottles in here. And the last section is the back pocket. Now this pocket is lined, but I don't have a tablet and I don't really stick my phone back here. So the only other thing I have in here is the changing pad that came with the diaper bag. Okay, now I'm gonna show you a little bit more about this diaper bag. So I'll just kind of give you an overview and then I'll show you detailed what's inside. So I have I believe it's called the Mountain Gray color. And I went with a gray color just for the fact that I could use it all year round if I wanted to. My other bag that I used for a diaper bag was yellow, so I used it in the winter last year, but it really wasn't my favorite thing. It wasn't really my favorite color. So I figured I'd go a lot more neutral this time. So this bag has a zipper on either side. And this is just for the main compartment. And I really did like that it had two zippers, and the zipper is really great quality. You have one main pocket in the front. I don't know if you can see. And this is just where I keep a lot of my things. They call it the mommy pocket. And I really 100% agree with that. I'll take the bow off. The side pockets are not insulated, but they do have elastic here, so they are going to expand, which is really nice. I can fit water bottles in here. I can fit her sippy cups in here, no problem. And it's the same exact one on this side. Now the back, like I was telling you, is lined. So it's like felt lined. So if you put any electronics, anything that has a screen in here, it's gonna be fine. It's not gonna scratch it. It's not gonna damage it. It's gonna be fit perfectly in here. I will say, I don't know how big of a tablet would actually fit. It's a decent size, but I mean, if you're getting bigger than an iPad, it's not gonna fit in here. Now it does have these two pockets in the front, and these are really deep. I can fit my whole hand in here, so you're able to fit a lot of things. And this one's just a little bit more narrow. But this whole inside is kind of like that nylon material. So if anything does end up spilling in here, it would be super easy to wipe it out and clean it. I don't think you'll have a problem with that. Same with the outside, actually. This is gonna be really easy to wipe down and clean. I've been using it for about 6 weeks now and I haven't noticed it get any stains on it. And I mean, I'm not careful with my bags, so. I'm really impressed at that. You have this back pocket that is completely lined like the inside of the bag. So if you want to throw anything in there as far as snacks or anything like that, that would be super convenient too. Now these two bottle pockets are insulated. So if you have anything cold, anything hot, I have put her cold milk in here and it has kept it cold. So I really do like the insulated pockets. The only complaint I have is these pockets are really stiff, and that might have to do with the insulation factor that goes along with that, but I think as I put her sippy cups in and out of them, they'll start to loosen up a little bit and it'll be easier and more convenient to use them. Okay, so this is my What's in My Diaper Bag video. I hope I gave you some tips and tricks on what you should carry for your little one, especially if they're over one. I found it's a lot easier to carry less and just to keep a few extra things in the car. This is the Ryla Diaper Bag Backpack. If you guys liked it, please check out their website. It's a really great diaper bag and I've really enjoyed using it. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and I'll see you next time.